You share some DNA with your siblings, which means if you have enough siblings, you have all of your parents' DNA. But how much DNA do just a few siblings have? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell if you want to be notified about upcoming episodes. Now, in the Genetic Genealogy Tips and Techniques Facebook group, there was a discussion a couple of weeks ago about how much DNA siblings as a group share with their parents. We know that a single child shares 50% of each one of their parents' DNA. Now, theoretically, if you add another child, so you have two siblings, then those two siblings should share around 75% of both of their parents' DNA. Adding a third sibling, you're going to go up to 88%. And what you can see from this pattern is that half of the amount left is added on for each sibling. And so each sibling adds less and less of the total DNA that your parents have. But at some point, you're going to get to the point where you basically have all of your parents' DNA. Now, DNA doesn't theoretically combine and recombine exactly how statistics shows us. And so what we can use is we can use some of the information that people already have gathered to see what this range is. So we know with two siblings it should be around 75%, but what is the range of that? Now, in the Genetic Genealogy Tips and Techniques Facebook group, a member suggested using DNA Painter in order to do this. And this was a brilliant idea because if you have grandparents, and if you have their grandchildren, when you're looking at where those two match DNA, what you're actually looking at is you're looking at the parents and where the recombinations were in the parents. And since that's what we want to find out, we can compare a set of siblings to a grandparent in order to figure out how much of the parents' DNA that set of siblings has. So let me show you how to do that in DNA Painter. So here we are on the website, and if you've never logged into DNA Painter before, you can log in for a free account that will have some limited tools that you can use. If you already have a DNA Painter account, you're going to need to use a profile. So if you're not a subscriber, you're going to have to delete the profile that you have in order to do this. Or you can subscribe and be able to have as many profiles as you want. I've created a new account, and the first thing I'm going to do is go down here and I'm going to create a new profile. And it's going to tell me a little bit about what information it needs. You can see that it needs the chromosome number, the start location, the end location, and the amount of centimorgans really to be able to paint information on DNA Painter. And it asks for a name. And in this case, I'm just going to call this my parental profile. Now, the first thing you need to understand next is whether this person is male or female, because that's going to determine how many X chromosomes it is going to be looking at. So for my example here, I'm going to use my paternal grandparents because I have both of their DNA. So this would be my father, so I'm going to select that he is a male here. And now I can save it and start painting. Now if I look down on this page, what you can see is that there's two chromosomes, one for the paternal, one for the maternal. So this paternal represents my grandfather, and the maternal represents my grandmother. And this is where it might be a little bit confusing because we're talking about paternal and maternal in different ways, but really we are talking about grandparents or we're talking about parents. Since we're talking about my father right here, these top chromosomes represent my paternal grandfather. And that means the other chromosomes represent my paternal grandmother. So that's one thing just to keep straight is that paternal and maternal in some cases actually means grandmother and grandfather. But down at the bottom, you can also see on the X chromosome that I just have a single chromosome because I specified that this was a male. And so this X chromosome is going to be from my father's mother, so from my paternal grandmother. But since me and my three brothers didn't receive any X chromosome from my dad, this is going to remain blank through the whole thing. So we're ready now to start painting. And if we click on Paint a New Match, there is a box that we can paste information in. So let's go over, and I'm going to use 23andMe for one of the examples, and I'll use GEDmatch for another example. So first, let me look at my grandfather. So I go over to 23andMe, and using the DNA comparison tool, you can see that I have my grandfather plus me and my three brothers, and I'm going to compare how much DNA we have in common. Now it has the pretty little graph, which I don't really need right now. What I want is I want that raw DNA data. 23andMe actually has that down below in a great big table. And so I can just copy this table and paste that right into DNA Painter. I'll go back to DNA Painter. I'm gonna paste all of this and then I can save that. Now it's gonna ask me, hey, do you want a name? And in this case, I don't really need a name because this is just my grandfather and my grandmother. Now, I'm going to call this ancestor, my grandfather, because all of this shared DNA comes from my grandfather. And it wants to know, is this match on my mother's side or on my father's side? Now, again, this is on my father's side, so it's going to be paternal. And let me just do a blue for the paternal side. Now you can see that this has gone through and it's painted all of those chromosomes based on all those matches that me and my brother had, and it's actually quite a significant amount. Now, if you want to see the percentage, what you can do after you've just put in the initial part is you can do a refresh of the screen, and up at the top here, it will have what percentage of that person's genome has been painted. And so you can see I've only added in my grandfather's information, so I have 47% of my father's DNA is represented between me and my three brothers. So over in GEDmatch, I'm going to use the multiple kit analysis. And what you can see here is in the first kit, I have put in my grandmother, my father's mother. And it's important that that is the grandparent kit because this is the kit that's going to be compared to each one of the others. Then I have my siblings all next. I click on the visualization options, and what I want is I want this segment search, and I'm just going to go and click on the segment search button, and it's going to create a document that has all of the segments that my grandmother matches with each one of me and my siblings. In this case, I want to download the segment match. I'm going to be able to open it and copy it into DNA Painter. Now the only thing you need to copy into DNA Painter is actually these columns right here. The chromosome, the start position, the end position, and the centimorgans. So back at DNA Painter, I'm going to paste this information into my file and I'm going to save this match now. And again, it's going to ask me if I want to name this. I don't really want to name it, but this is going to be my grandmother. And I know that this is from the maternal side now, because this is not my maternal side, this is my father's maternal side. So that's why I say that can be a little bit tricky in trying to keep that straight. So this is the maternal side. I'm gonna make this pink. And let's go and let's see what we have now. So now you can see that I have both of my chromosomes painted all the way through. There's a couple of little gaps here and there, but for the most part, it's all painted. I can refresh this, and that's going to tell me overall how much of my DNA has been painted. So remember, I said with one sibling, you have 50%. With two, you're going to have about 75%. With three, you're going to have about 88%. With four, it's going to go up to somewhere around 92%. Well, me and my three siblings, we have just over 88%. So we got a little bit less than what we would expect. And a lot of that is because I don't have any of the X chromosomes. Since it's just boys here that's being compared, I miss out on a complete chromosome. So that would actually go up, you know, above 90% if I had all of that chromosome. Now, the other cool thing that I can see about this is I can see, hey, how much of on the just my grandfather's side do I have? And I can see I have almost 96% on my grandfather's side. So just between me and my three brothers, we have almost 96% of the DNA that my father received from his father. If I look at the maternal side, we can see that I have 81% of the DNA that my father received from his mother. And again, that's because we're missing that X chromosome. So how can this be useful? Well, I've created a collection sheet here. And on this collection sheet, what you can see is it's basically going to ask you for this information. So the first part is, are these grandparents paternal or are they maternal? So are they through your father or are they through your mother? You select that. Then you choose the number of siblings, because this is important so that we can divide out what the ranges are for each set of siblings. And you can choose between 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 siblings. And then you're going to record that total percent of DNA. And this is that percentage that we see up at the top here. Now, when I'm looking at all of it, this is the percentage that I want, that 88%. So in this case, let me just go through and I'm going to say that, hey, this is the paternal side and this is 4 siblings. And the one thing here to note is even if they're half siblings, you can include them in that as long as they all share the same grandparents. So the total percentage of DNA is going to be 88%. Now, if you want to, you can also add in those other two values. So this would be my paternal amount, which was 96%, and my maternal amount, which was 81%. So I'm going to put in 96 here, and I'm going to put in 81 there. And the goal with this is, as you'll notice, I'm not collecting any kind of private information as far as your name, your email, your kit number. None of that's needed. All that's needed is the percentage of shared DNA that you have using this process in DNA Painter. And you can submit as many as you want. Let me point out here what I mean by that. So, for instance, let me just highlight this right here. If you have yourself and 2 other siblings, then you can submit information for all 3 of you together with 1 set of grandparents. And if you happen to have the other set of grandparents, you can also submit it for the other set of grandparents. If you want to, then you can also submit any 2 siblings. So maybe you and your brother, and then also you and your sister, because it may be different percentages that each of you combined share with your mother or with your father. Now, what about if you just have 1 grandparent? You don't have both grandparents from a side. You can still submit information also. What you'll find is that instead of being in the, let's say, 70, 80% range, you're only going to be in the 35, 40% range. So it's really going to be about half of what you would expect otherwise. And that's okay, because I can use those numbers to help create a spread of what you can expect to find for different amounts of siblings. So if you would like to be a part of this project, then go to the link in the description below and you can click on it and go and submit your information. And this is a great way, if you haven't ever used DNA Painter before, to quickly use DNA Painter and start to get accustomed to it. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and make sure you share it with all your friends.